Thank you.
Okay,
yesterday I talked about the essence of light and the balance between darkness and light and how light moves in us. Now I'm going to talk about ruling. And in order to do that, we go to Genesis 1, verse 14. And then God said, let there be lights in the firmament of heavens and divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs, seasons, days, and year. Let them be for lights in the firmament of heaven to give light on the earth, and it was so. And then verse 18, 17, God set them in the firmament of the heavens to give light on the earth and to rule over the day and over the night and to divide the light from darkness. And God saw that it was good. So what happens here is that, let's have a look if I correct. Yes. The earth is green to me. This is the earth. And God said there was a firmament above the earth. This is the firmament. It's called Rakia in Hebrew. And in the firmament, he placed the stars. And he also placed the sun over here, and he placed the moon, well, let's make a blue moon, and they govern over the earth. So the stars, the sun, the moon, and the sun, they rule over the earth. What happens is that God said it was good. And that's what we need to understand. This is the original plan of God, that there is a kind of rulership. And this firmament is a dividing means of the waters above and the waters below. And the waters below became the sea on earth. So we have this combination as explained in Genesis 1, verse 14 to 18. There is a firmament around the earth. In the firmament, God placed the stars. He set the sun and he set the moon, to rule day and night and to govern the earth. There is an institution here from God. So what does it mean to us? That he puts things in place, but it is man who can govern from these seats. So what happened in the history of man was that all the ancient civilizations knew that in order to rule the earth, you had to govern something from above. You had to govern from an area that is above. Let's put it a little bit down. So what they did, they created this area based on the zodiac. And I make it only for this time, 12 separations, and that one. So this is the zodiac as we know it, the constellation of the star systems that are around the earth. So in ancient civilizations, every civilization had their own zodiac, their own system of governing the nation or the nations they were occupying. So we have an Egyptian zodiac. There is a Babylonian zodiac. There is a Chinese zodiac from China. Let's make it like this. There is the Vega zodiac in India. So the Mayans had a zodiac, the Aboriginals had a zodiac. And in the end, the Greece, the Hellenistic zodiac, and that became the Western zodiac. So in order to govern a group of people on the earth, you needed to have access to the zodiac. You needed to control the houses that are in the zodiac. So if you were a conquering nation and you would try to increase your influence by capturing, gaining land on the earth, you needed either to control the zodiac system of the nation that was in the earth there, or to conquer them. We see this, for instance, in Australia, where the British people came in with their zodiac system based on the Western zodiac, and they were the Aboriginals who had their own zodiac system. And in order to conquer them, they had to suppress them. The same is true nowadays. China has an own zodiac system that is based on 60 years, 5 times 12. So if in order to control the Chinese, you need to overcome their zodiac system. So the problem conquerors have is that they have to destroy the zodiac system of the nation that is in the land in order to gain access to that. So what happened in Egypt, for instance, they built the nation according to the stars. When you look at the pyramids at Giza, you see them, that they are aligned in a certain construction. And some people say they are aligned in the construct of the Orion belt, like the pyramids of Giza are in that construction. So what happened was that when God sent Joseph to Egypt, something happened before he went. Let's look at the text. He said, he dreamed another dream and he told his brothers, look, I have dreamt another dream. This time the sun, the moon, and the 11 stars bow to me. And all his family got upset. How can you say that? How can you say that you are the one entering into the heavens and that we must bow to you? But it was all a foresight of what God was going to do to Israel. So when they brought Israel to Egypt, when God did that, they were there, and that is very interesting. They were there, another color, in the Age of Taurus. And I come later to explain how these ages function. But it's now to know that there was an Age of Towers. There is a certain time period where the constellation of Towers was prevalent. I explain that later. But it's now for us to know that when God sent Joseph and later on Jacob to Israel, he sent them under the authority of the Age of Taurus, and the whole worship in Egypt was based on the cult of the bull, the worship of the bull. So when Moses came, he was at first at the court of Pharaoh being trained in the system of the Age of Taurus. But when he led the people out, he led them into the desert, and there on Mount Sinai, God gave them their own zodiac system. Oh, sorry. I need to draw a circle. So what happened? God gave them another zodiac system, and these are the 12 houses of Jacob. So what God did, he gave them a system that was above the system of Egypt, and for that matter, every system that was in the world. So the system of Egypt controlled the land, and the empire of Egypt was very strong. But when Jacob's houses were erected on Mount Sinai, they started to control this system based on the worship of the bull. Now, something very interesting happens. At the moment that Moses received the Ten Commandments on Mount Sinai, it marked the end of the Age of Taurus. And something interesting happened. The people that were with the Israelites when they came out, they started complaining about, where is this guy? Where is Moses? And they started to build a golden calf. And as you might know, a calf is a small bull. So when Moses came down with a new zodiac system, with a new way of controlling, the old system tried for a last moment to build the altar of the calf. And it was Aaron who did that. So Moses came with the commandments of God and the institution of a new zodiac system. And what did he do? He destroyed the calf. He destroyed the symbol of worship and the symbol of the age. And he entered, and that's interesting, they entered into the age, the correct color, of Aries. The age of Aries. So what happened at that moment, from Taurus to Aries, it changed. And the calf was destroyed, but that was not the only thing that happened. There came a new priesthood. The Levitical priesthood was established at that point. And what we learned from Dr. Owens in his teaching on Israel and the Zodiac is that this Levitical priesthood superseded the Zodiac system of Egypt. Why? Because the sacrifice of animals was based on the gods of Egypt. They sacrificed the bull and they sacrificed the ram. So the sacrifice animals of the old age of Taurus are used as sacrificial offering, thereby controlling and rising above them. That is why Bilaam said, you cannot defeat Israel as long as they are in righteousness following God. You have to make them sin in order to conquer them. So Bilaam saw that God gave them an own set of ruling, I call it the 12 houses of Jacob, and it was above any other system of that age. And this 12 houses governed the nation of Israel, and by these 12 houses, they could enter the promised land and conquer every nation there, because they ruled from a different dimension. So now I need to explain. Dr. O mentioned in several times about the age of Aquarius and the age of Aries. So what does it mean? Where does this come from? So let's go to some very basic stuff. There are 12 houses or 12 constellations in heaven. And when you look around heaven, it is a circle of 360 degrees. That means that every house has a circle of 30 degrees. And that's the partition, like I said. Every house has approximately 30 degrees. So why, how does it look like? Well, I can show you here. This is how the constellations look like. And have a look, spotlight. Oh, that's not the correct one, sorry. Can you see the red marker? So here we have, let's have a look. This circle is the circle of the sun in the sky. And this is Virgo, and this is Libra, and this is Scorpio, and they all are around here. They go around. So currently, we are at the verge of entering into the age of Aquarius. And that has to do with this little point over here. Let's make it very clear. It has to do with this point, what we are seeing here. When we have the equator on Earth, you have two tropic rings. This is on the northern hemisphere. This is the tropical of Cancer, and this is the tropical of Capricorn. And what happens that the sun is coming up in the northern hemisphere, comes to the top, goes down again to Capricorn, and goes up again. Well, this date is June 22nd. This date is December 22nd. This date is September 22nd. and this is March 22nd. What we see is that the sun moves to the northern hemisphere and goes to the equator back again and comes in the southern hemisphere and then goes up again. In order to establish where in which age we are, we need to look at this point. That is the date of March 21st, the 21st of March. And we have to look where does the sun stand on that day in which constellation. And I can show it over here. This is this point. There. This is the equator. This line, this is the equator. And this line is the solar eclipse. And at March 21st, the sun is standing here. And you couldn't see, this is the constellation of Pisces. Let's have a look. This is Pisces. So the sun is in the constellation of Pisces on March 22nd. Here is the constellation of Aquarius. And we now believe that this point of the sun is moving into this direction. So that we are living now in the age of Aquarius. And you can see it over here. Oh, I have to skip annotate. This is the point the eclipse is standing in Pisces. And you can see here, this is Pisces. This is Pisces. This one. And here we have Aquarius. I need to delete a little bit. This is Aquarius. And you can see there is overlap. So this point over here is moving in this direction. So when we look at March 21st, we can look at the sky and see where is the sun standing? Is it still in the constellation of Pisces or is it standing in the constellation of Aries? So why is this important? Well, constellations and the ages are periods of approximately 2160 years. That means it takes the sun 2160 years to move from one constellation to another. The Age of Towers was in the days that Moses liberated. I'm now going to screen now. In the days of the Age of Towers was when Moses liberated the people from Egypt. And under the reign of Towers, they came into the new age of Aries. And in that system, something changed. The bull was no longer God, but the bull was now becoming a sacrifice. The ram was no longer a god, but became a symbol of sacrifice. So it all changed. And there was a new priesthood set in place. The Levitical priesthood started at the age of Aries. Then 2000 years later, the age of Aries ends approximately at the birth of Christ and the age of Pisces began, approximately in that period. And again, something was sacrificed. What was sacrificed? A lamb. And Dr. O teaches in the Zodiac course that you could read for Aries the ram, or you could read it as lamb. So the end of the age of Aries was marked by the death of the animal that was being God in the age of Aries. And the ram was the god of war. It was the god of fighting. It was the god of butt-heading. You know, the ram uses his horns as a way of attack. So when Revelation and Daniel speaks of horns, you must understand it's spoken from the time of Aries. It's about talking about a ram, and it's a time of war, of engaging strongly. But then Christ came, and the ram or the lamb was sacrificed on the cross, and the age of Pisces emerged, the age of the fish. And in Greek, it's called Ichthys. So now a completely new age emerged, and something else happened, the destruction of the temple. So there was no sacrificial system in place. That there was the law, but there was no place to do it. So there was again a change of priesthood. And what entered was not a Levitical priesthood, it was a rabbinical priesthood. It came into being over the ages, over the centuries, that the rabbis replaced the function of the Levitical priest. So we now have in the age of Pisces, the most important thing in all, you can see it all through the Middle Ages, is that teaching became very important. Like Calvin was a man who was a teacher and instituted that the teaching of the Word of God was the most important thing. And so all these things changed in the Middle Ages. So on the top of the age of Pisces, we had major teaching programs, and we are still at the end of it, because Dr. O said yesterday, where do we send our children? We send them to Bible schools in order to make them teachers. But it is an influence from the rabbinical priesthood that the teaching functions should be the most important. So I go back to my notes now, because I have covered a lot of things, but I'm not finished yet. I hope I have some time left. Let's go to my yes. whiteboard again.
Yes.
Yeah, I have some time. Thank God. So we have this Levitical priesthood, but Jesus came and he instituted another priesthood, another way of governing. And this is this one. And these are, let's have a drawing. This is a system based on the 12 disciples. Well, we all know that it's 12 plus 1. So 12 plus Jesus Christ, and later was replaced by Paul as the apostle. In the houses of Jacob, it was 12 houses plus Dinah. And let's see if the erase works. Can I? Yeah, it works. And in the ancient systems, it are the 12 animals, or that's why it's called the zodiac, except for one, but leave it at 12, plus the dragon, Draco. And it's interesting to see that in the constellations, Draco is in the center. So what we learned when was it, Saturday or Sunday, the teaching of Revelations, what you taught, sir, the mouth of Drago, the mouth of the beasts, and the mouth of the false prophet, they are now influencing from this system over here, they are influencing the earth by speaking from this system. And why is Israel so attacked? Because their zodiac system isn't controlled by this system. That's why 3% of the Jewish people in any nation can govern 80% of the world. Because they govern not from the system of the world, but they govern from the higher system of the 12 houses of Jacob. And then Jesus comes along and says, listen, I've got a new system for you. This system can govern even the system of the houses of Jacob. And it's very interesting, but Dr. O wrote a book about this. This is Hashemayim 1a and 1b, and this is Hashemayim 2. So what we see is the number 13 over here, 13 over here, and 13 over here. What we need to understand that all of these things are trading floors. And there are not only three, it goes up to seven systems. And I think, if I understand the teaching correctly, that each system is linked to one of our bodies, because we have a fiery body, a celestial body, an ethereal body, etc. We have all these bodies, the natural body and the soulish body and the spiritual body, and every body inside of us has a system by which we control and govern. So when you have 7 times 13, you get 91, which is 10, which is the number of godly government. So in order to learn what it all means, we need to understand if we really want to govern the earth, we must ascend into the heavens, because most Christians are standing here and they are very sad because, oh, sorry, that way. Take your razor. They are very sad because they are under control. They do not control the environment. They are being controlled. And we see this nowadays by the false prophet called the media, under the influence of the dragon and the beasts in this zodiac system. They are controlling everybody on the earth that is standing here. So what did Christ, what did Jesus do for us? I have to make it anew. This is the earth. And we have all these systems. This is the Egypt system. This is the houses of Jacob. And I think I had this color for... the houses of the disciples. So what happens, this is interesting, what we call, this is the sun, and everything here is under the sun. This is mentioned 29 times in the book of Ecclesiastes. It's under the sun. So when you are governed from the sun, remember the first picture, the sun and the moon over here, they govern, and the star systems, they govern, but they are occupied by people with wealth who have known to gain access of these houses, and they control the earth. But when we arise above this veil, as you might say, the Jews did, but there is another veil over here, and we can reign with Christ, because what happened, we can rise up here, because what happened is that what God promised us in Ephesians, he worked in Christ, he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in that is which to come. And remember, the word age has to do with the change of Aries to Pisces to Aquarius. So all these ages are governed by people in power. So that is one text. I need to wipe this out because if I change the page, then it will stay. Go to the next tab. He raised us up together, made us sit together in the heavenly places, that again, in the ages to come, he might show us, Marios, the exceeding riches of his grace and kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. So what God is promising us is that he's given us this place in the heavenlies, far above every principality and power that governs here, and even the principalities and powers that govern in this realm. We are seated with Christ on this plane. That is what the ruling part of light means. We ascend into the heavens, into the heavenlies, not only to control the Jewish, Judaic, Judaism system set up by the 12 houses, but we can also control the demonic system set up by the ancients. And remember, it's not only about Egypt, it's about Babylonian, it's about the Mayas and the Indians, the Vegan system and the Maoris, and all these civilizations had their own zodiac system. And in the end, Greece had also the Hellenistic astrology, very famous. And if I have understand the lessons correctly from Dr. O, it were the Danites that came out of Israel, who came into Greece, and for the hatred of God, they set in place a system to fight the system of Israel. And they put in place all these demonic forces in the Hellenistic astrology system in order to fight the system set up by Moses in the desert. And there is a war going on that level. But then Christ comes and rises up above every system, and we are called to come there and to conquer. So why is this important? Well, let me show you again. Biblical examples speak. In Daniel, this is the prayer of Daniel after the king said, "I have a dream. I will not tell you the dream, but if you won't tell me, I will kill you." So what did Daniel do after he received the answer? Because it's a little bit above, it says he went, he had the dream was in the secret revealed in the night vision. And then he said, this is very interesting, "Blessed be the name of God forever and ever. Wisdom and might are his." Listen very carefully. "And he changes the times and season." This is talking about Genesis 1:18. This is talking about the government of times and seasons and signs and years and days is set up by the government of the stars, the sun and the moon. So when God changes that system, kings will fall and new kings will arise. So at the verge of changing an age where new systems come in place, you need wisdom and might, but also wisdom and understanding to understand the deep secrets, to know what still is in darkness, but is becoming light to us. So now we talk about this coming age of Aquarius. Come on. This age of Aquarius also is a change of priesthood. It's the order of Melchizedek that is coming. And the order of Melchizedek tells us there is a new man coming. He is neither Jew nor Greek. What does that mean to me? Oh, this is an E too much, sorry. I hope I spell it correctly. I'm not a native speaker, please be patient. Neither Jew, to me in this context, means we are not part of the zodiac system of Israel, the 12 houses. Neither Greek means we are neither part of the ancient zodiac systems that are demonic in essence. There comes a new zodiac system based on the 12 apostles. Oh, that's very wrong writing. Sorry, I go too fast. The 12 apostles plus Christ. And together we govern from a different realm. And when Israel is redeemed, they will be lifted up to that level. And that makes 24 elders in the throne room. But they first must be redeemed. As long as they are in the old system, they are blinded, like Paul said. Because as long as they are blinded, they can't see. And I would like to end with reading an introduction to a very famous book. And Dr. O will know what it is, of course. And it, because at the beginning of the Age of Pisces, it's very interesting. Let's do the stop share. At the beginning of the Age of Pisces, spirituality came in and the Age of Christianity became. And you see that the carrier of the Age of Aries, the Ram, Roman Empire, fall down. But Also, spiritual enlightenment came in the first two centuries. They were not written down until later, but they came in that century. And I read a passage here that the critical moment of change would arrive in conjunction with the Aquarian Age. Then a massive quiet revolution would occur, and the Erev Rav, that is the mixed multitude that traveled with the Israelites out of Egypt, would be pushed aside to make way for a period of enlightenment and the restoration of the authority to the people. The Aquarian influence will be a subtle force that will permit the gradual spread of the Holy Grail until it becomes an integral force of mankind. By the time the corrupt authorities become aware of what is happening, their frantic and desperate measures will be to no avail. This talks about that the revelation of what is written in the Zohar will come to fullness in the age of Aquarius, and it will bring us as mankind and into an enlightenment, into an understanding of a level we have never experienced before. We will be ruling from a place of light. We will be no longer hidden in darkness, but we will ascend to the heavens and govern from the seat of Christ, because every plane has a seat. And it says in Revelations, like we learned in Revelation 16, the throne of the dragon and the throne of the beast. Where are these thrones? They are in the celestial zodiac system that is in place. Inside the 12 houses are 12 thrones, and they are occupied by demon forces. But we need to rise again. There are 12 houses of Israel, and there are thrones in them, and there is one throne in the middle, because Dinah is the female principle in middle, and is the Levitical priesthood has taken that over. And so we rise up again a level, and there are 12 houses of the disciples of Jesus. And Dr. O described this in his book, but for us to understand it, when it comes to ruling light, it's much more than shining the light with your lamp in the darkness. It's standing from a position of light, and that the light that is inside of us governs the nation we are standing, governs the country we live in. And then scripture says, people will come unto your light. Jesus says in Matthew 5, you are the light of the world. And the world in Greek is cosmos. It's not the earth. Please, when it says world, it means the whole cosmos. The light of us shines into the cosmos. And even people that write about the age of Aquarius tell us that it is an age of technology. It is an age of networking. It is an age of space traveling. Things will completely change, but we need to leave behind a corrupt nature, a corrupt characters, our corrupt behavior. And that is why we see in these days the rising up of fighting against something that is coming. And the people on the street do not know why they are so angry, because they are being controlled by something that knows that when Christians are getting understanding, wisdom, and knowledge about what is going on and how to perceive this and how to access this and how to get control, nothing will prevail. Their systems will be completely destroyed, and then mankind will be free. Human beings can be experience freedom if they are governed by mature sons of God. And that is what Ron says is so important, because we need a vessel in order to rule. We don't rule, like Doctor said, we don't rule from the spiritual realm. We rule from the earthly realm in the body, but we are seated in the heavenly places. And I hope you understand by this short teaching that this heavenly places is in a realm of houses and is a seating above everything. And when the light that is in us starts to shine, when we crack our outer shields, our outer veil, then our light will shine into the neighborhood, and people will come to us and ask us, what can you do for me? How can you help me? And everything good will be attracted to us. And that is the age we are emerging. And I think I have more to say, but I feel I need to stop here.